I grew up in a predominantly West African community in an area that looked pretty much just like this. When I was about 12 years old, some of the kids I used to play with after school disappeared. I asked my mum where they'd gone and she said, oh, they've gone to their white mums. That was my introduction to a practice some call baby farming.
The practice dates back to the 50s, the early years of the Commonwealth. Parents from the newly independent Nigeria and Ghana came here to study and work. They placed ads for kind foster homes in magazines like Nursery World in the hope of offering their children a better start in life. This little boy's parents placed him with a white foster family in the 60s. He grew up to be the Olympic athlete Chris Akabusi. This house in Portsmouth was one of a succession of foster homes and the only happy one.
So it's really quite strange actually to come back to the house, you know, and to be here.
He was four when he was first left.
I remember coming over from Nigeria and my mother saying that where we were going was going to be our home. I don't think I fully understood what that meant, but I remember standing in front of this house, looking up there, that this was going to be our home, but I didn't realise it meant my mum wasn't going to be there. Your mum goes, there's no fanfare, bom, she's gone. Because we were all black children, this is going to sound ridiculous, I didn't know I wasn't white. The only time I really realised what it meant that I was different was when I was at school, and I thought I was white, and then one of the mums said, no, you're black.
Chris and his brother were moved to another family where they suffered serious abuse.
We were made to drink our urine. We were really physically abused.
And there was no social services to try and help you?
No, you know, it was sort of unofficial fostering. You know, people just did adverts and you looked more than family pets, to be fair.
In the 70s, the law was tightened after 18 West African children died in abusive, unregistered foster homes. At 15, Chris was reunited with his mother, but it was too late.
I have issues with attachment. I live on my own, and I do lay that at the door of my very first attachment experience. But have I really understood why she left me? Not really. She was a young woman. She was one of the chosen few to leave Nigeria, to go to England, to get an education, to go back to Nigeria, and to be part and parcel of the nation-building process.
The politics have changed, but the practice continues. In the 1980s, David Ayo Gorgeous spent his first 5 years with white foster parents Maddie and Joe in Burgess Hill.
I was a very confident child. Like, you could put me in anywhere and I would make friends with anybody. In the area and in school, I was the standout black child.
For David, being raised by another family was part of his cultural heritage.
Anywhere you go in Nigeria, you'll see local people that their children are the community's children. And I think that's what they carried when they came over here. I guess it was new in the fences, it was a different culture, different race looking after someone's child.
David's mum Vicky found Maddie and Joe through friends.
He was special. He needed somebody and I was there. You just love them, don't you? You love them as your own. I never saw colour. It's a child that needs love and attention, and that's what you're there for. Somebody's put them in your trust.
At six, David went back to his mum, Vicky, in London. It was a culture shock.
I went from having toad in the hole and stew with dumplings to jollof rice and pepper, and I hated pepper.
David is proud to say he has two mums, but it has left a legacy.
So the moving around definitely was unsettling. And I still feel like I'm a gypsy, like, till today. I can go to another country and just live and be fine.
For Maddie and her husband, David was never far from their thoughts. And when his foster dad died, David's first school report was discovered folded neatly in Joe's wallet.
I thank Maddie for looking after me and making sure I was a safe, happy child. And then I was able to go back to my biological mum, and luckily, it's turned out for me a great thing.